Because good, somewhat thirsty afternoon, if you could say it, if it wasn't such gloom or such a gloomy day in that outside. You're listening to the General Manager Takeover Hour. Long story there. I know you're probably thinking, why? But I'm here with Jim from Shadowrow. Hello, sir.
How's it going?
You having a good time?
Oh, yeah. Love coming in here, man. This place is great.
Yeah, we're a little off the wall, aren't we?
Yeah.
Just a little? Or yeah. A little more?
It's just enough.
Just enough. Good, we're there. That's what we try to do. That's our thrive and thrills and stuff. But off of the side subject for right this second, yeah, I guarantee we'll probably slip off topic again.
Oh, yeah.
It'll happen. It's going to happen at some point in time, not including DJ Nightmare comes.
Oh, yeah.
But I'm going to start off in that, since you're here in that, with your own, compared to, what was it, now 3 weeks ago with Brilliant Night.
Yep. Sitting about in the same seat here.
No, technically it was that one.
Oh, yeah, it was that one.
See, I actually watched later today, not actually during that, but I'm good. But going to start off a little personal type stuff. Like, your first instrument you ever played. Not the kazoo, not a recorder, anything like that.
It would have to be the drums, and I could tell you pretty much the exact time and place. It was when I was younger in elementary school. I had a friend Dan from Moon Rocks I was telling you about. Those guys, he had drum set, his brothers and stuff played, and man, as soon as you feel that, you just want to play, and that got into band class when I was in, like I said, elementary school with him, and we all played all the way up through junior high and high school, and in the process picked up other instruments, you know, guitar, bass, keyboards, just started messing around with computer software, doing all kinds of stuff, and you land right here today.
Started off on your own journey in that. So that's like me. I started off, band 5th grade, through 6th, and I had drums, trombone, you name it, and all that. Then, high school, got into jazz band, and started doing bass.
Oh, man.
It's been a few years, though. I couldn't play you anything off of an actual bass.
I played when I was in school bass, but I stopped playing for a while. We went on to doing the rapping for a little while, and then I got back into it with another band, the Medicine Makers, and we did a bunch of shows, we did a bunch of stuff, and recorded a bunch of songs, but things didn't work out. So
that
really got me back in the bass, and then that's when I fell in with A Brilliant Night. I knew Brian, my cousin's actually his girlfriend, so that's, I don't know if we even said that last time we were here, probably not, but, and then...
I don't think.
Yeah, we just started playing together, and it's been working, so...
Good old times.
Yep.
Not including what actually got you into going into music.
Like I said, just discovering those instruments at a young age and feeling that feeling and watching those videos of the rock stars, I guess.
I wanted to be like
that. Yeah, I wanted to be like that. But then you get to that point where you've come close to that, and then you just want to do it now for yourself, for entertainment of other people. And that's really where I'm at right now. I really want to just make something that people are like, oh, that's good. I don't care if I get money. I don't care if I get famous off it. It's just about being in that local music scene, being on that stage and performing in front of people and showing them, look what I can do.
And just get your name known and so on and so forth. Very good. Not including, I'm trying to think my other dark, deep question that I'm going out with my deep, dark questions. I like putting people on the spot. Except I need to get one of those big giant lights that actually shine down on you. You're on the hot seat. We can actually do that. Oh, no, wait. I don't have that sound effect. Damn it. I'll fix that at a different point in time in that. But the other thing in that, when you're writing songs in that, what inspires you? Life experiences?
Other experiences in life that I've had with other types of music and going to those shows and then being around people and just weird off-the-wall stuff sometimes on there. Like, I try to challenge myself on the CD also and try to write songs that don't even have any swearing in them. Like, there's a few on there that I didn't even have to edit for this. But I find it more challenging to try to write those types of songs with intellectual words because, I mean, you got swear words. There's so many words that rhyme with those words, and it's just, let's see what we can do. And there's a few on there that are like that. But then there's sometimes where people want to hear that, and it's necessary, and I think it's funny sometimes.
But, yeah, like the modern day rappers say, you know, blah, 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 you know, and you can't barely understand them except every, like, fifth word.
Yeah, and that's why I'm trying to separate myself from that. I'm not trying to, every other word's going to be that swear word. Or
then the auto-tunes, too.
Yeah, I don't use none of that. I just use my own voice and a little bit of effect to give it that sound. But
yeah, off.
Yeah.
Like I got you.
I do everything myself, so it takes time and...
Oh yeah,
I have no engineers, no producers, or anything. I've got a couple of my friends that are starting to get into it. I'm trying to show them how to use the software and help me out and do stuff. And
that's what I was going to say. You're probably using, you know, okay, I teach you how to do this. You know,
you push
also,
this
can
button.
You help me out, you know, with this.
Yeah,
I got you.
At the same time, they're sitting around. We sit in my basement all the time and hang out. So we throw ideas around and we'll come up with weird stuff. And I'm like, oh, I can make a song out of that. Or we got a couple right now that are in the making. That are just some hilarious stuff. And then we got some serious stuff. And then just some off the wall stuff that I hope people are gonna like.
I like this. I like this a lot because that's sort of what I am up here.
Yeah, and it's not even just all about the rap. We got things that like I got other like dance type music going, like techno type music, and like we do stuff like that on the side and just to be funny. Can't wait to keep going.
Oh yeah, especially is that sort of the theory that with them wanting to sort of learn what you're doing in a way, sort of, you know, well, you know, I'll help you sort of learn stuff, and yeah, I'm going and also here near what I can swap, you know, you help me out too.
Yep.
Sort of like a fair trade or trade type thing.
Yep.
I gotcha.
I give them credit on the CD. Like they can put their name on there. They're going to be all over the stage show anyway, so it doesn't matter. Like I said, we got things planned out. There's going to be like live drums. There's going to be guitars on stage. This is going to be just a regular rap show. A white guy on stage rapping with dreadlocks in his hair, like you've seen before. That it's not going to be like that. This is going to be a different show.
I got you an idea. 70s get up.
Each show be a different style, yeah.
Afro, that's always what I wanted to do here.
As I say, if you want, you just jump on stage doing that while I'm playing. I invite everybody come out, do something. Keep making a show.
What I always want to do, big giant disco ball, walk in all 70s, get up, chains, all that, wig, afro. Oh, now, that would be creative.
Yep.
No, you were expecting that one. No. This is completely unscripted.
It's kind of like a disco in my basement, though, because I got it. It's all set up with a giant studio. I got lighting and fog effects and all that. So we'll play Wii Bowling. It'll be Cosmic Bowling. It's funny. Flip on the switch.
Ever took out an amp?
No.
Wii controller?
No, I'm waiting. We say it every time. No one's dropped it yet, but it's coming. It's got my first 300 on that game the other day. So.
Oh God! Silver or hammered?
Yeah, both. Like in the middle.
I got. I like this.
Yeah, you got to hit that certain level and then you're good to bowl.
Oh, that's like me. I can do pretty decent when I'm there.
Yep.
Oh, this is going to actually be a really fun time. You could just tell this. This is really off the wall stuff. This is what you should be digging.
Yeah, we do our share of partying down there. There's a couple songs on there that tell you.
Oh, especially did you actually create those when you were, you know?
Oh
there?
Yeah, yeah, mostly all of them.
All of them?
Not all of them. A couple of them. All right, all of them probably.
Actually try to produce stuff and try to remember, oh, what
yeah, you get to that
does
point.
This do?
Yeah, you get to that point, you're just, all right, we'll pick this up tomorrow. You come back the next day, you're like, what was I doing, man? I got to turn this over here, turn these verses around. This don't sound right at all. And then you just continue to drink again and then do it again. you can't get anywhere, so you got to take that time and get serious and sit down and start doing it. And
I have your head pounding.
Yeah.
That's the other one.
It was this morning after last night. I was like, oh. Got the nervousness of this coming up, and then I got to get this CD ready, and just a headache at the same time.
That's not fun stuff. Not fun stuff in that.
No.
Not including my other deep, dark secret question.
Oh, no.
You'll like this one. The weirdest experience being on stage.
I have to say, a couple of them were like a brilliant night. Like I said, with Brian almost kicking me in the face a couple times, because he gets crazy on stage, kicking around and jumping and doing that. Yeah, I mean, we've had people just run up on stage and start dancing. We've had just all kinds of weird stuff. people throwing stuff because they don't like us, but I don't care.
Oh, yeah. Well, that's like here. You get random people to come and do that in the window.
Well, yeah. I just saw someone not too long ago walk by.
And you just like, you know, what is that? Yeah, you know. Well, I don't know. I just like coming into this room and talking on a mic, you know. Maybe they should come and take a look at the actual plate outside the door. Not including actually did any, was it, like crowd surfing?
No, I never have.
Never?
No, I've helped people and watched them. No, I never have. They never wanted to lift me up. I'm a little bit smaller than I was back then. So those shows, yeah. I wasn't riding out there.
This is one of my priceless other questions in that about things, yeah.
Yeah, I've seen some funny spills, people doing that.
That bad?
Missing teeth, blood all over, falling, hitting their face on the gates.
Or people just scooting away and
yep.
down on the ground.
Another reason I didn't want to do it. We did the mosh pit.
The fear?
Mosh pits were fun. I was in there. A lot of those.
So it's the fear of it, in a way, in case of what's going
to
happen.
Like, I'm big to begin with. I don't want to fall like that guy did.
They have a nose job coming?
Yeah.
Because they're breaking your nose when you
come
down?
I see a girl, she gets up, she has two missing teeth, and one's just hanging there. It's like, yeah, I'm not going to do that now. I believe that was at a Twisted show years ago.
Oh, God. This is going to be great stuff, man. Yep. I can feel the great out of it. Not only, yeah, whenever Spencer comes back.
Oh, man. Yeah, he was fun last time.
Oh, most definitely. And the fun times will continue. Segway Condom to come in again. Yep. And say hello and put him on the spot just for the heck of
it. Yeah, let's get Spencer in here this time.
But the other priceless things... You actually want to do one of your tracks first?
Yeah, we could do that.
Yeah. Which one do you want?
Yeah, you could just start with the first one. It's kind of like an intro and it's a short little song. It's like from the perspective of a zombie. So
yeah, zombie.
Yeah.
The zombie walks.
Yeah, and this one was challenging to write too because it was all clean. There's no swear words in this one. So It was trying to do it with the blood and the gore fantasy world and not
so
using those words.
A little bit of the inspiration zombies in that with it?
Yeah, a little bit.
Okay.
Pretty much.
So, coming up right now, Zombie Walks, except I need to make sure I hit that on.
As we drift into the oblivion called progress, from the shadows from which he dwells, he speaks as worlds collide in vain to replicate his likeness. He's lived beyond the judgment day. He's walking the valley of death, and now, as he arises from the ashes to reclaim his throne, you will witness the one known as Shadowrow. I'm all good, looking through the barricade, made a coffee table wood, a look in my eyes like I wish a human would, pitchforks and swords can't distort my contortions, losing limbs like abortions, blood rushing in mass proportions, and all I need is some forceps, to take your last breath and leave your souls to rest, do the zombie walk, and do the zombie walk, and do the zombie walk, and do the zombie, Sam! Do the zombie walk, and do the zombie walk, and do the zombie walk, and do the zombie, hack them in half and watch them crawl. Legs fall like bullet shells and leaves in the fall. From the living to the day to the dawn. Mass hurts a swarm till the living is gone. And his body's on the lawn. Window shades drawn, not a sign of life. Won't be long till it all turns to ice. And the dead are walking on, stalking alone. Keeping memories of the living and the blood forever on. You could call it the end, but you know you're dead wrong. It's a whole new start, a whole new song. Do the zombie walk, and do the zombie walk, and do the zombie walk, and do the zombie. Sam! Do the zombie walk, and do the zombie walk, and do the zombie walk, and do the zombie. Sam!
Ha 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 ha!
Now we're back. I like it.
Walking like zombies already.
I know my advisor will like it. Because he's prepared for like the end of the world and that. Man. He has a bug out bag over in his car at all times.
I know a couple people like that. I'm not worried about it. I'll let it happen.
Let it happen, then, you know, just panic at the last moment.
Yeah.
It happens.
It happens. If not, I'm just going to join them. So.
I'm thinking of a very good, especially that song, going and figure out a way. It's just every keyboard. Because it's a great thing because April's Fool's Day, Tuesday.
Oh, yeah.
Sit there and program for every keyboard button. So he hits that and it just keeps playing. That would be hilarious if you think of it.
Yep.
I like this idea. I hope to God he's not watching.
Especially April Fools. I know a couple people who have it coming. They know who they are.
Oh, God.
Every year?
Do you do the classic thing?
No, you just try to get him with anything. Multiple times a day.
With the salt?
Oh, yeah, stuff like that.
Yeah, you switch around, put the sugar in the salt shaker.
Fake blood's always a good one. Broken glass, stuff like that.
Wow.
I've scared people so bad I've heard him scream. Like, I've never heard him scream before. Good time. Dummies falling out of attics.
Wow. That's extreme. We got far.
It was like a little monster guy tied to a string, and my buddy went up there to... I don't want to talk about who's going up there to check on, but it came down and scared him pretty good. It was good times.
Ever thought of doing that actually on stage?
No. We're going to do some funny stuff on stage. It's going to be a good time.
To this extreme or less extreme?
It's going
to
be, let's say, Michael Myers and Jason on stage dancing around doing stuff. I don't know, stuff like that. These are the ideas that we throw around at each other. So I just got to get these guys to get in a costume and get on board with me and do it. So that pretty much got the live show down. We got a good set going. It's just now we got to add that theater effect. Because I said you don't want to sit there and watch a guy do the same thing everyone else is doing the whole time. We need... I don't care if you're a midget in a car driving around in circles with fireworks. Let's do it.
Yeah.
Got you on that one.
Except, though, I could see fire departments having issues with the car, though. Being indoors to that, because of the exhaust. But I do like the idea. That would be perfect to do outside. I'm not going to lie. Because we're coming to the summer, that would be a perfect thing for that ace in the hole to use at a later point in time. I love that.
A pretty good video, too.
Oh, yeah. Just imagine that. You could get major hits off that, big time. Just think of that. Because I guarantee if you search YouTube and that, you couldn't find an actual band or anybody that actually thought to that.
Nah. We had original stuff that we do.
Yeah, you gotta post some of this on YouTube. This is gonna be entertaining stuff.
Well, as soon as the live show starts, it's gonna be a constant feed of different stuff every day.
You actually know when that's gonna happen?
I'm waiting. I gotta get stuff together. I'm still waiting for contacts to contact me back. I mean, certain places. I'm interested in everywhere. I mean, anywhere I can go, it doesn't matter.
Doesn't matter.
Just get the word out and play and have a good time. That's what it's about. The entertainment and the good times.
Mm-hmm. Try to get downtown Cleveland in a way.
Yeah, just anywhere. Yeah. Make some connections with some of the places down there. I'm just not quite ready. I guess I want, when I go in there, to be ready 100%.
I got you.
Yeah.
And also many of the different like local places like brewery. Nah. Yeah, brewery. They bring in. That's the other thing is I've been trying to think of where to hit up and that, because like our advisor with his separate band around this area is trying to come up with like where to come, because he's mostly in Ashtabula.
Yeah.
And I'm like blanking on, so I know it's like the Willie Brewery, you got Coaches.
Yeah, there's a ton of them out there. You just gotta go in and talk to the people and send messages. And I've received a few requests here and there already, and it's just I had to turn a couple down because I'm not ready. I want to be ready, but I want to get the CD finished first and then get the full set ready to go, the stage, how we want it to look. And because I got a couple guys behind the scenes helping me, as in when it comes together, they're going to be there to help me do it, but as in everything else, I'm doing everything else, so it's nerve-wracking.
Yeah, it's probably pulling all different directions that, you know, here I got to contact these people, then, you know, that, then, you know, places and that.
Yep.
Yeah, it's that sort of like you feel like you're getting pulled all over the place.
Yeah, at the same time, so I got to a family to take care of at home. I got the kids and the wife, so it's got to do all this on the side and the free time, and it's works.
Hard to manage, huh?
Yeah, and she's good, and she goes to school here actually, and she told me not to talk about her too much on here. I know she'll get mad. I'm sure she's watching right now.
Or she's seen in class right now that we should be afraid.
Nah, she's not here today.
Okay, good. Because otherwise I would have to resort to my other idea. Well, I always want to do, in case someone got angry at that, because they got mentioned on air, put in like a little hole in half like a Nerf gun and sit there and get them.
Yeah, she...
See, these are the random things we think inside the box. As in this box.
She'd shoot me with more than a gun.
Huh?
She'd shoot me with more than a Nerf gun. I love her, though.
It was the thought, because we can't bring paintball guns on campus, come on.
Yeah.
That's the easy actual entertainment value, if you think of it.
I'm gonna shot with a couple paintballs. Not good.
No.
No, feel good.
I gotcha. Because I'm in that crowd. And no, it's not that fun-ish. Especially if you're just wearing like this.
Yeah, you get hit in some places that you just don't want to get hit with them.
Oh, yeah.
I wasn't aiming. Yeah, I bet. Mm-hmm.
So, besides, you have this one CD.
Yeah.
You have another one coming out?
Well, I got one. So, this one is almost finished, and then we're going to start working on another.
Like, second.
Different one. That's a different style than this. Like I said, we got the A Brilliant Night stuff going on the side of that. It's just, it's all over the place, but...
Welcome
yeah,
to my life.
There's a lot of songs that aren't on that one that I'm going to actually cut, and then there's ones from the past. So we've been doing this for a long time. I've got at least 3, 4, maybe 5 CDs worth of stuff with other people and everything over the last 10 years of time, so... It was basically just breaking it all down into what I want to keep, what I don't want to keep, how I'm going to fix this to make this sound good, and in the end, I end up throwing most of them away anyway, which... I knew. And then you find there's songs that are lost in time. There's songs that you've never heard before because you made them, burned them on discs, and then somebody loses the discs and you just never see them again, and there's no digital copy, and it happens over years.
Oh, I imagine. Also, you could always go and do that. Take different collections from all over the place and actually do one CD.
Yeah, I was thinking about that, doing an old... Look at the back, a throwback type of CD.
Where like, all first started.
Yeah, it's going to be a new song, like, and then an old song that was influenced by it, and then a new one, then an old one, do something like that. Or there have been ideas that I've been throwing around, thinking about doing that.
So I sort of like that, yeah.
Yeah, because there's some people that still ask me about them old songs, so it's like, eh.
I imagine.
I'd have to redo some of them, because I'm up to that point now where I'm not happy with anything I record anymore, so hear every little note of every little song, and it's... gets in your head sometimes, and
yeah, like if you hear something that's, you know, sort of just distorting, it just annoys you.
I got 5 people in the room. I don't know what you're talking about. I don't hear it. Oh, I hear it. It's like, oh, I hear it.
And then, so you're just, yeah, really being like I do.
Yeah,
and, that like I was listening to different actual college, but they're like stationed that, and you could hear their songs that they're playing. You could tell they're distorting, and it's really high. It's like
yeah.
Have you ever heard of Capresti? Do you ever heard of it? Turn it down, for God's sakes.
Yeah, I don't turn it down. I get to the point where I just throw it away, start over. I've done that so many times, so many takes of so many songs. It's a lot of people don't understand about the process of it. Yeah. When I have people who are trying to help out, that you got to see in that booth and you got to record it, you're going to mess up. And sometimes there's some funny outtakes, and we'll keep those and use them later and other stuff. But it's a process.
Or just the comic value of
yeah,
it.
Yeah, just listen to
go
later.
Play back.
Oh, we do all the time, and it's funny stuff. There was one last night. I don't even know if I could say that on here, but it was pretty funny. My buddy Mike, he's been there since the beginning. He's been there, man, third grade we've been together. He's a good dude. He comes over and he gives me a lot of ideas, and he helps me out a lot with just everything, and yeah.
Good.
So everyone, Mike, Dan, all of them, they all come over. 2 Mikes, 2 Dads. It's confusing down there.
Oh, you tell me. I got, what is it? Is it 2 Nicks, 2 Dans? Or no, wait, 4 Dans.
Yeah, popular name. You guys hear that?
Oh, I... at first in the head. You know, you're Dan 1, you're Dan 2, you're Dan 3, you're Dan 4. But now it's, you know, well, Dan, you know, S, Dan.
Yeah.
Because otherwise I would probably be pulling my hair out by now.
Yeah, we just give each other names, but a lot of them I can't even say on the air. So we just know who we're talking about when we say it.
Yeah, hey, what's your face? Well, it replaced that with what's your face.
Yeah.
To actually be Sir Politically Correct. How about that? Good compromise?
Yep.
But then, I gotta see. Want to actually get another one, too, in?
Yeah.
I'll yeah. That's definitely.
You can do the last one. I mean, that's the
newest. Last one?
Yeah, that's the newest one. That's the one that
newest
just,
one?
Just was released this morning, actually. I put it out when I was coming here, and we worked pretty hard on it last night. It got finished up, so a lot of people.
How many retakes?
Oh,
or just one?
As the beer was flowing, it took more time. That was just it was a lot more outtake. The first beginning of it went pretty smoothly, and then we started drinking a little bit, and then it got a little harder, but I finished a lot of it up this morning, late last night, and I think it came out pretty good. It's a whole different style than the rest of the CD's been, so yeah. Hope people like it.
About this
a little
one.
Faster.
Live one now since the whole retake. Longest song that you had to retake. How long it took to finally get to your thing, or how you like it?
Oh man, it took me to. It was a couple way back in the day. That was when we were recording on computers, though, and it was me and my one partner was doing it, and he was worse than I was with the tediousness of it, being so meticulous about everything sounding perfect. So he'd be crazy 50, 60, 70 times in a row, and 4 or 5 times I'm like, all right, that sounds good to me. And we learn from that, we get better, and he's doing pretty good now, so. And yeah, some of them take a long time. Some of them you get in there and everything comes together and sounds great, and you're like, let's roll with that. And but some of them they take a while.
Yeah, that's sort of one of my things, sort of on the spot things. I have to add that to my deep dark questions.
That's a good one. I was like, yeah, the ones it depends on what you're doing too. I mean, whether you're doing metal or rap, it's all different, because then you got everybody playing instruments and they got to be together. And then when you're doing this by yourself, especially if you're making all of the beats, you got to build it around what you're doing. And it takes some time, a lot of tedious little editing work.
I know your life all too well.
Yeah, I bet you do here.
Especially here. I'm really a stickler with certain things. I hear some sort of redo.
You start seeing wavelengths in your sleep.
I'm not going to lie. When I was sitting here and doing all the liners and all that, it's like from, was it our whole band artist week? What is it? I have 120 different cuts of liners.
Oh, man.
Yeah,
that's a lot of editing.
Oh, you think? How was it? 27?
Man, you gotta export all that stuff, and oh, man.
And what was it? 27 bands or artists, not including two of them didn't leave CDs. They did own, like, generic sounds type thing, but yeah.
Oh, yeah.
But just think of that. And I did that just one night.
Yeah,
just,
you could come up with something from behind it, yeah.
No, one night of just doing that, what is it, like, 6 hours?
Yeah, that's about how long I go at a time. 6-7 hours. Like, I gotta take a break here.
But so I make sure I get it right. So Planet Magic.
Plant Magic.
Oh, Plant Magic. Yeah. Okay.
Yeah, these guys.
Okay.
A lot of influences in this one.
Uh-oh. Good or bad?
They're good.
Okay.
A lot of people on campus will think they're good.
Okie doke. Here we go.
Amateur DJs.
Italy, I'm smoking. I'm looking Chinese from all the trees. Mike B's got the potent, got me choking like Hocus Pocus. And then you high, you know we smoked a blue dream. Confidential bubba, kush kind. Never believe all the weed that I seen. Over the top is some nitro green. To kill a motherfucker, wanna dance with me. Some grand any purpose, some OG. Hypnotized by my own beats. I'm hitting the streets with a flow so sheet. Couldn't even touch it with a pole 10 feet. Need a plea to give a piece of the street. I just wanna smoke until I fucking collapse. And get my feeling relaxed. Stumble to the end of the world and relapse. Watch it all just fade away. Nothing to say, got a fuck that's cool, let's smoke it right away. End of the day, we still say high, never cushion my brain. Steadily I'm smoking, I'm looking Chinese from all the trees. My bees got the potent, got me choking like Hocus Pocus. And then you high, you know we smoked a blue dream. Confidential bubba, kush kind. There's a glitch up in my mind, right in my mainframe. Got me feeling like I'm floating, got me seeing all the pain. Got the indica strain, this light is sparking in the dark. Playing no games when the session's about to start. And this shit pops off like crazy. I don't even know what the fuck I'm talking about. Yeah. Get me down when I paint the town. Every room that I enter be in a cloud. Every cookie that smoke be Girl Scout. I flip this shit and we getting out. Punch a motherfucker right in the mouth. I smoke another roll and I'm getting out. Still looking for the street but it's cotton mouth. Where this bitch be at with my motherfucker rap? Sleep for days, no time to be sober. Move my shoulder before that ogre. Crushing my chest just like a boulder. Holding my ground just like a soldier. Never giving up cause I'm growing older. Nothing be done till I say it's over. Throwing the bong that four leaf clover. Smoking it up so hand it over. Piano key frequency. See your life in the distance. The aroma of the weed can't be covered by the incense. Getting so high that you believe that this is business. Just listen to this shit. Hypnotize and then you get this. Steadily I'm smoking, I'm looking Chinese from all the trees. My bees got the potent, got me choking like Hocus Pocus. And then you high, you know we smoked a blue dream. Confidential bubba, kush kind. Steadily I'm smoking, I'm looking Chinese from all the trees. My bees got the potent, got me choking like Hocus Pocus. And then you high, you know we smoked a blue dream. Confidential bubba, kush kind.
One.
Oh, yeah.
Because I'm a very smart person, I'm using the actual wrong CD player. Yeah, the one that goes reverse from whenever it ends down to zero and that.
Oh, yeah.
Or wait, I can actually tell you now. 247.
Oh, yeah.
Almost 248 because it's 64 seconds.
A little pretty long. So.
Oh, yeah. It's still decent, I'm not going to lie. I like it. But you want to nail 3-2?
Yeah, if you want, yeah.
Okay. So two, or wait, to my sparrow?
Sorrow?
Yeah. Wow. Yeah.
It's all good.
My brain.
I'm sure the names will change again. They always do.
Okay.
To me, I wouldn't even put names on any of them, but then that confuses people.
Yeah. What's that track?
That's the best time. I said, what are we going to call this one? I don't know.
Plus, you'll, at some point, kind of run into too long of numbers.
Yeah, I get people say, just say something and write it on there.
Yeah, when you get the track to 100, well, what's that track?
Yeah,
track 100.
Did we already make a song with that title? I think I have three of them.
Yeah, you can't use numbers to label it because that'll just get really confusing. Oh, okay, what's this track? 2000. Yeah, that's going to really mess with somebody. But no one's ever done it, I bet.
No.
I like this idea. No one probably has done it. So you could be really unique outside the box.
Yep.
Only thing is, yeah, people will find it weird, though.
Yeah, people get confused fast. Like, you know, with stuff that they're like, oh, all right. Yeah, mm-hmm. People's attention spans are a lot shorter today.
That's the truth. I'm not going to lie. But I'll get 3 right now.
Yes. devastation in the blink of an eye. Suicide is an escape for the weak will. Contemplation, separation, supplied. Not trusting in a false god, followed by his lies still. Every time he tries, he can see right through the pills. So every time he lies, another angel falls and dies still. The crack in the wall is a scratch, another kill. No more sadness, he's had it with these creatures of habit. Giving him static can only feel so automatic from day to day. How the you know what I'm feeling anyway. You never cared, only when the world revolved around you. God forbid that it stopped and everybody dropped too. To my sorrow, is there no love for me tomorrow? Is there a blink, a tear, an emotion I can borrow? A link to my fear, another pill I can swallow? Another path, a motherfucking leader to follow? No. A distant shadow on the wall, can't crawl or fall no more. Makes my mind seem like a drug without a fiend. Circumstances taking over me, making my eyes bleed. Confrontation of a nation filled with hate and devastation. Can't relate his ass to teeth, eating away inside the heart of many men from the start. I contemplate while I start, going straight for the heart with a stake. No mistakes to make this time as I take away the hate from her veins and change the ways of getting on. Keep running till dawn, then it's time to retreat and feast on the souls that are gone. Leave the memories and ashes on the lawn. When you look in my eyes, you'll see that I'm gone. To my sorrow, is there no love for me tomorrow? Is there a blink, a tear, an emotion I can borrow? A link to my fear, another pill I can swallow? Another path, a motherfucking leader to follow? No. As I bridge the gap, my hesitation set me back. The fear from death's exposure breathing down my back. This subliminal attack will only last a minute. Step into the mirror, see just what the rest of the world is feeling. I keep my flows electric, the center of attention. Not to mention I'm infectious, deflective reflections. Every corner that I turn, sun makes my skin burn. I'm concerned as I learn I'm not from this earth. But it's okay, I'll continue this campaign to reign until it rains the names of these forsaken kings. To my sorrow, is there no love for me tomorrow? Is there a blink, a tear, an emotion I can borrow? A link to my fear, another pill I can swallow? Another path, a motherfucking leader to follow? No.
Or as what my marketing teacher said last fall, people are just weird.
Yep.
That's what her sum up thing. If you take one thing out of this marketing class here, people are weird.
That's what actually the basis of one of our next songs I'm working on here is
People Are Weird.
Weird people. It's a good one. We were talking about it and we got a bunch of ideas around and just putting them into the words now, so
sort of like what, you know, how people just don't understand.
Yeah, little things that people do that everybody knows about, but they feel like they don't know that we know they're doing it, stuff like that. And
or in this, you know, things that sort of like bother, you know,
yeah,
somebody, you know, well, this person just constantly, you know, always needs to say this word, you know.
Yep.
I like this.
Stuff just like that.
I need to hear this when it comes out. This would really make my life appreciative.
I got tons of concepts and ideas. I got a lot of stuff that's in middle of being made and not done yet. Stuff that I'm just going to probably end up trashing. And it's just a long process. You just go in there and...
Just do me a favor. You got to do that song.
Oh, I'm going to work on it. This is what we're going to do.
I need that song. Why? Because this it would be very entertaining.
Yeah, we got a little idea for some skits of people telling stories. We gotta just sit around and see who's all got familiar stories. Like, we'll come up with a subject and see who all has a story about that subject. Like, all right, we're gonna put this on the CD and mix it in there somehow. And there's a couple good ones bouncing around right now.
You'll hear them when they come out. Waldo. Where's Waldo?
Yeah,
I like this. I like our troll of Lake Effect Radio that finally made his appearance, George.
How's it going, man?
You should message in, man. Give me a few ideas, man. I had to put them at work.
Yep.
Especially if you want your award. We talked about, what, Monday? Or was that last Wednesday? I'm not sure. One or the other. Sort of blurs in.
I'm giving him an award?
Yeah. Because we were talking about you, George B., the troll of Lake Effect Radio. It's always on.
Yep. It deserves an award.
Yeah, it's actual. We sort of made it up. I said, you know, you want to work? Yeah, okay. Yeah, it's. He's a good. He fits us all too well. I have an actual follower like him. I'm not going to lie. We come up with very good stuff.
Oh, man.
Very good stuff.
Yeah, it sounds like it here. It's a good time every time I come in here. So.
Oh, you should have seen yesterday. You'll like this one. We had one of the DJs in that here. Was it her Monday, Wednesday? Was it 11 to 12 o'clock? She sings pretty decent that, and she doesn't want to sing on air in that.
No.
So we came up with a compromise and actually brought it out. I had to get like 40 people signatures or 40 people to say yes to it. And got it within, what, a half hour or so? Man. Then she changed her mind and then said, well, if you get, you know, another 60, another so 60. It's 100, you know, I'll do it back to back.
Oh, man.
So within a matter of another half hour, it came up 6. I hope the god Leanna's not listening.
Oh, man.
Yeah, she somewhat hates me after that, but yeah. Got within a matter of an hour, 100 people to say, yeah, she should sing.
Let's give her another 100, she'll be fine.
No, if I get another 100, she says she'll do it again and that, and we have to try to make a fundraiser out of it and get money out of it.
Oh, man, that's a good idea. I want to get to do some stuff like that, too. I was thinking over the summer, throwing some shows by myself, because we got a pretty decent setup, and we're going to try to do that, get a bunch of local artists to come in and do some songs and some sets and do it all for charity, pretty much. I mean, I don't really want to make any gain or anything off of this. It's strictly for the entertainment, and it's a hobby. It's something to do. It's sitting around all day.
Well, music's a good stress release, in a way. That's sort of
until you get down to editing.
Well, that nowadays now, but you know, when you're getting a band or like, you know, in middle school, if you have that one person that needs to be annoying and needs to be on your case all the time, and like in high school, it's good stress relief in a way, especially for me, you know, playing that, just zone out.
So we did in high school. Every day after school, we'd go and, all right, we're going to go in the studio. Studio consisted of our computer with the little microphone, you know. We made CDs. We did shows. We did shows with even big name people at sometimes, and it was it was a good time. And I fell out of it for a while. I said, you have kids and everyone gets a family and grows up from it, and then you get to that stable point where like, I could pull this off, I could do this in my spare time and maybe make something of it. If not, oh well, just have a good time doing
it. It's worth
it.
A try.
Yeah.
Especially like us, or was it, so I really only did jazz band my senior year, and that we decided during the spring concert, last song, and that after everyone's leaving, that ACDC, It's a Long Way If You Want to Rock and Roll.
Oh,
that. And just doing it off the top of our heads. We didn't perform it really at all practice it. We just sort of, you know, going to be almost sort of good college students, but we're actually graduating. Thought, oh, well, you know, we could, you know, pull it off. And that's with Jack Black and School Rock. So it's like, this just seems like a good idea. Let's do it. It didn't come out half bad at all.
Yeah, we've done that. A couple right from the computer editing board to the CD to, we're on our way to the show. Let's see if we can pull this song off live. Like,
we've done that plenty of times. Ever came up actually with the actual song on the fly before a performance?
I did a lot of freestyling back in the day. That's how I actually got into it, was from sitting at parties, and I never knew I could rap or anything, and then we just started doing it. I was into a poetry a lot, so I wrote a lot. I had books and books that I wrote, so I'm like, I'll try this. And I was into some rap music. Like I said, my cousins and my friends got me into it, and then, it took off from there. I started actually writing the stuff and putting it to actual original music, so it came out pretty good, and now I'm just going up and trying to get up again and see what happens.
And time will tell.
Yep.
But definitely, so that's one thing is, except I should have brought that up when we're talking about actual like concerts and that. We're thinking about trying to do something like that here, actually. Try to get together, because it's been years since here we actually ever did like a concert or any sort of
thing. That sounds like a great idea. They should do that, definitely. There's tons of people, and I'd love to get involved with that.
Oh, yeah, that's probably It's the weird, horrible thing is the theater over there. It's always bugged in that because
college,
you got Jazz Fest, Communitas, you got, like, 1 year my high school came up here for the spring concert.
Wow.
Random. So it's always, you know, all over the place with that. That's one thing is we always wanted to sort of try to pull off. So they used to do that. I mean, what was it? The latest document of that was, what, 80s, I think?
Man, I need to get on that then. I'm more than happy to show up. I got a lot of people that would be more than happy to be involved in something like that. They could raise a lot of money for good causes. They could definitely do something with it.
Oh, yeah. Especially, you can come up. That it's definitely to keep you in mind that if we actually inspire into that, worst comes to worst, it's going to have to be the gym down there.
Hey, anywhere, I'll play anywhere, anytime.
Would be better if it was a stage because of acoustics and that, but
yeah,
might have to make the compromise depending on what's happening with that.
Yep,
it's one of the groups down the hall, they were trying to do that for October next year. They're trying to do events. Was booked a year and a half ago.
That's crazy.
Yeah, a year and a half ago was booked. The day they were trying to get.
It's crazy I was booked and I've never heard anyone say, I'm going to Lakeland to see this show. Never heard that.
All it happens, you would be surprised.
Man.
Not only we run the many ads for many things going in there, so we even sort of know.
There's a lot to do with exposure too. Like, people get annoyed on Facebook constantly posting stuff. Go ahead and unlike me. So I'm trying to promote myself. I got a lot of things I got to get out. So if you don't like it, then just unfollow it. I don't care. I'll get fans.
That's
back.
What I do with ours.
I'm not in it for your opinion and your. If you like it, you like it. If not, then don't listen to it.
Yeah, everyone's got their opinion. That.
Yep.
You can't completely shoot them down. That, like me, I sit here, put myself out there. In a normal semester, 15 weeks, so twice a week, so yeah, about 30 shows in a semester.
Damn, that's a lot.
So you think,
lots of practicing.
Oh, I've been doing it for 4 years, man.
Yeah.
4 years, been in the horrible spots, the good spots, the on the really fly spots. So yeah. This is me. Except I need that gospel music all of a sudden come out.
You gotta get a soundboard with some sound effects. Get a whole bunch of pre-made ones.
Oh, if you only knew. Like this. These hot buns here, I have 12 of them. Yeah. I always want to get the dark, deep music. The dun-dun-dun.
Oh, yeah.
And have that every single time someone walks in that back door to play. Welcome to my thoughts inside the box. I'm a very creative person deep down inside.
Oh, yeah.
Especially, what was their other crazy idea? We always wanted to do. I have a crazy one. You'll like it. Darn. What was it? Oh! Like the. Yeah, that one was it, the wheel, or one of those big giant wheel of fortune wheels.
Oh, man.
About it on that wall for like random things to happen in a day.
Oh, man. Who should do that?
And spin it around if someone's bored of that.
Everybody get up and switch seats. Something dumb like that.
Oh, you should see the one time we did a Chinese fire. Not joking.
Oh, man.
Not doing like metro parks, and that, a few of us went out there to do the whole around and read off doing narrating that. We got the bright idea when we were in it, do a Chinese fire drill, so we kept on switching wagons, running around. Hey, we had amusement.
Yeah. And we did a lot of crazy stuff back in school, man. Okay. A lot of stuff I can't talk about on here, but everybody knows how we used to do stuff. It was good times. We still do
good
a bunch of things.
In the band class.
Oh, man, that was the best time of my life was with those guys and just the concerts we did and all that time. It was just
about the instrument you made. Lockers.
Oh, man, we'd mess with people a lot, throwing paper and horns, and we did a lot of fun stuff.
About the instrument lockers, did you ever try to lock someone in it?
No, I've never done
or pretend to.
I've seen people locked in lockers, but I've never done that.
Yeah, like what we decided. Because we had to mess with the one person because they went around and they actually knew how to play every instrument they pretended to be.
Oh, man.
And we had this big giant, like, this size door, and it's like back to back.
Yeah.
And you have, you know, the flute one, you know, this, or, you know, was it flute, clarinet, then you had the trombones. Yeah. And that. So deciding that, hey, we need to get that. It just went and shut the door. It just
latched that thing.
No, we actually just put the latch on. So you had the combination locks. Each one, yeah. You know, trombones, all of them knew that one.
Yeah.
Yeah, we just went and put the latch on.
Yeah.
We didn't actually put a lock or anything. And they were sitting there, I can't get out.
Oh, man.
Yeah, and all they needed to do was push it open.
Reminds me of the days they pushed me over in that porta potty. Never forget that. There was actually a video of that at one time, but I don't know whatever happened to that.
Uh-oh.
Oh, yeah, they thought it's funny. They thought it was.
Till then, all of a sudden, the blackmail comes out.
Man, it was a good time. That was a long time. They just got done building Wendy's around the lake over there. And it was all woods. That's where a lot of the chaos ensued, was in those woods over there. A lot of people.
Woods.
Right over by Lakeway Woods and Men on the Lake, where Mark's is now.
Oh.
That whole lot, when it was a wooded lot, that's that was our grounds. We spent a lot of time in there.
I know where that is, because that's on the way to my mother's dentist's office. That's over there near the church.
Yeah.
So, yeah, St. Bede's and that?
Yep. Yeah. Look, I went to that one, too. When I was young.
Okay. I like this. This is starting to turn in very deep stuff. What am I joking? This isn't deep at all.
I'm sending flowers up here tonight.
Huh?
I'll send you some flowers up here tonight.
No, I'm just joking. You don't have to send flowers now. So I won't be here that late to get them.
Oh,
and more than likely being here and that some random person will either A, take them or...
We should see who that is.
Yes. Do it.
It's her. Hello? Hello?
Did I get up there?
What?
You get to go?
You're on the air right now.
Oh, shit.
Watch your mouth. I gotta turn you off a speakerphone, man.
Your teacher knows.
All right, I'll see it.
Your teacher heard you. She's going to hunt you down and fail you.
We were talking about how mad she's going to be. It was good stuff right there.
I know. This is actually hilarious. Should I do the funny thing and say her teacher's great failure because she knows that?
She's doing pretty good here, though. She's that shows you how much she's watching.
Exactly.
I should have said that. Huh? Thought you were going to watch.
Yeah, that would actually be a priceless thing. But yeah.
Yeah, she's doing pretty good here, though. She does a lot,
no,
man.
I was
she's
trying to do a false little advertisement type thing. Hey, your teacher heard you. Yeah, you're going to get failed. Oh, that's what I do.
Yeah, she's... I don't know how much she likes coming here, but she does it, so...
Mm-hmm. Yeah, no, it was sort of just my random fake conversation type thing. If you only
knew. She's going to kill me tonight, I already know that. You put me out of the air. Yep.
Hey, you called in the middle of it.
Yep.
Hey, if you were watching the computer, you know, you could see this.
She thought I was done it for.
Uh-oh. SpaghettiOs.
You're not funny. Call me when you're done. Oh, everyone else thinks it's funny. I'm laughing. He's laughing.
Other people and the random people that are actually logged in, especially George, you're letting me down, man. He really is. I'm going to really take back that award thing. I'm not going to or send it to you or have you come up and get it now. He keeps this up now.
Oh, man. Yep.
But yeah, we got, what is it, two more songs.
Oh, you could put a, yeah.
And the fourth one. Which one? Good. Fourth?
Yeah, do the fourth one.
So I know it's two.
Yeah.
Two. Contradiction.
Not that long either.
Bad Habits?
Yep, The Bad Habit.
Okay.
It's just recently recorded also.
Not last night?
No.
Not with the beer?
No.
Okay.
But with beer, probably.
Probably, yeah.
I don't remember.
Yeah, it
happens. Yeah, it was.
Oh, well. And here we go.
As I push silently through the night, you can tell that something just ain't right. I reminisce about the things that I've done, all the graves that I dug, all the times when I thought that I was done. But it could just be the blood in my eyes. I can't seem to focus on the prize. No more time for the lies. As I feel, this is about to get real. Every inch of the steel in my heart, now it never heals. There's this terrible feeling that I get when I tend to remember all the things I can't forget. But I brush it off as demons screaming from the ceiling of my motherfucking mind, searching for time to regret the why. There's this terrible feeling that I get when I tend to remember all the things I can't forget. But I brush it off as demons screaming from the ceiling of my motherfucking mind, searching for time to regret the why. No one ever gave it back then. Where were all those people in the end? Fake and pretend, but it's all good as I plot my revenge. You looking underneath your bed, wishing I would. As I stalk, as I walk, as I creep, as you sleep so peaceful. Never expect that evil in me. I never wanted it to ever end this way. But today it'll change as the rage will erase the race. I couldn't believe or accept what had to be done. For every ounce of courage, for every pint of love. And now that it's over, and I'm sober and I'm hung, the blood in my lungs for the last time I'm feeling done. Another swift exit from this mess. I'm feeling stress from all these motherfuckers. I get this off my chest, one at a time, you motherfuckers. Will die because my bullets are rhymes. I'm making you blind for keeping it time. There's this terrible feeling that I get when I tend to remember all the things I can't forget. But I brush it off as demons screaming from the ceiling of my motherfucking mind, searching for time to regret the why. There's this terrible feeling that I get when I tend to remember all the things I can't forget. But I brush it off as demons screaming from the ceiling of my motherfucking mind, searching for time to regret the why.
Back yet again. I like this stuff.
Getting yelled at over here on the phone.
Oh god. This is not gonna be good.
She'll live.
Very good.
I try to get around my stuff all the time. She won't do it.
Especially I should have you actually throw out your site too. Oh, where they can actually go and check these out.
Yeah, it's just at facebookshadowrow.com. That facebook.com/shadowrow. That's it.
Okay.
And then that gives you the link to Reverb. I'm on Instagram, Twitter. There's everyone. Everything.
Yeah, we should have nailed that like half hour ago.
Just Google it. I'm sure it'll come up. Facebook it. Google it. It'll come up. Everything's all linked to everything. So.
Well, no, we should have actually done that half hour. Yeah, I guess that's what happens, right?
Yep.
But though, if they're watching on the stream, they actually see the event of it. So.
Yeah,
they can figure it out. Or I hope they could read. Yeah, you definitely need to do that one song about people's little...
Oh, quizzes. Yeah. The little things.
See? Especially after that story about the parking here at Lakeland, you need to do it.
Oh, yeah.
So I can promise you, I'll put that in here.
Parking, fast food employees, just everything, you know. there's a whole list of them out there I'm going to get.
Yeah, you need some inspiration with that? Just look at Lakeland Problems. You can find some stuff there.
Yep.
Big time.
And don't forget a brilliant night at the Agora, May 24th.
Yes.
Next month. Or month after. I keep thinking it's April already.
I know. Time's flying. When you're having fun.
Yep.
Or you're loving what you're doing.
Yeah, we'll be out there rocking that. And like I said, I'll have shows coming up this summer, so I'm ready for it all.
Definitely shoot me one, or whenever that's happening. I'll definitely try to make it.
Yep, I'll let you know. Because I'll have a list. It's going to all happen at one time, so.
Okie doke. Then we have our next song.
Silence is the solitude.
Okay. Wow. Okay.
This is probably the shortest song on the CD.
Yeah, I was thinking something else. But though, my contacts are being funky for some weird reason. Man. Up here. Yeah. Feels dry.
I'll never put contacts in. It freaks me out. The whole eyeball thing. Just can't do it.
So here we go.
To speak with thee. These lies had no forgiveness. A body full of sin. A voice to kill the witness. No sorrow for the wicked. No excuses for the sickness. He stares so blank. The ghost follows with persistence. Rain falls in waves and shatters in the distance. Lost and never found. Obsessed with no convictions. Death consumes us all. Can't identify convictions. Stretch beyond the means of taking care of business. He stares forevermore and breaks within an instance. Close way out so far. He never even listens. Silence is the solitude. Price of his existence, a place so cold, the soul separates the visions.
The clock is the wheel, let it spin into oblivion. No more silence, the ticking is getting him. I'm feeling so undone, I'm joining desperate today. I'm feeling so unsung for all the choices that I made. Aborting the young one, a hope for another day. In my mind's eye, watching all your gods pray. And what do I say that you haven't heard before? And every bit of strength it took for me to get up off the floor. And every window that opened is such another door. And everything is never enough, you always wanting more. I'm crawling up the pavement, so scattered and so torn. And when I come back to earth to see my true form.
It turns into a very good story the next day.
Yeah.
So.
Right.
Yeah, that was a really not a good experience.
Yeah, I bet.
Fishing,
man.
That side one. But yeah. You have anything else to drill us about?
Not much. I'm viewers? Sure next time I'll have a whole nother CD for you and a whole list of dates, and we're going to get it rolling here pretty soon. So.
I like this.
Yep. Get you some other people to come in here. I know they need to get their music out. There's a bunch of them I know that got stuff that people need to hear, and it's pretty quality. I mean, the Cleveland local music scene around here has got some really good artists. There's a lot of them have been through here too. You look at the wall, I recognize a couple of them. I mean, they're just, this is a good scene to be in. I like it.
Cause I had to say though, with your one message and that saying you really like what we're doing, that's probably one of the most greatest comments I ever had.
Yeah, it's good. Actually, it's good what you do for these guys. Like, you're gonna come in and just get it out to whoever. Don't matter who's listening, just anybody. Like, even just us here, and it's good for people. And like I said, there's a lot of artists around here that need to get their music out because it is good, and I know it's good. People that I have around listen to it. So
I actually took that and posted on like the members page and that here about that, and like many others when. Yeah, Brilliant Night too. That post on your guys' page and that, showing them and that, because everyone really had a good time doing that.
Yeah, those guys love coming in.
Except that sort of Thursday was a little bit more chaotic in a way, trying to change out people.
Yeah,
but
it worked out. It was pretty good.
Oh yeah, because no other College Station around here is crazy enough to have 27 different people come in a matter of a week and change out every hour.
Yeah.
We're one of the unique ones. Go to the extreme.
Yeah, I think you pulled it off, though. Pretty good. Watch a bunch of the videos up there. A bunch of good talent that came in here. I like to see them back, too. That's it's cool.
Yeah, but it's been a pleasure meeting you from one time that I just came across. I'm trying to think how I... When was it? Just going on YouTube once and seeing... Actual Brilliant Night.
Yeah.
And watch a video. It's like, okay, then what was it? Like, so that was what? I want to say end of February. Then we were talking about doing that whole band week thing. So what? I'm trying to think, the 20 something or something February? Then seeing you guys, and it's like, we started that and was really picking up. It's like, I'll give them a shout out, and that it's been a pleasure.
Yeah,
just by coincidence.
Yeah, Brian came out of nowhere. He's like, "Oh, you want to go do this radio thing?" I'm like, "Yeah, sounds good to me." Came in here. This place is amazing. You guys are great here, and I said I had to tell you. Yeah, you guys did a great job, and love what you guys are doing here. And it's been good coming in.
It's been a pleasure.
That sound
man.
Out there.
good time, especially I know because you're getting your calls.
Oh yeah, there are now. Bugging me. Mm. It's never ending.
I know. Welcome to my world. But it's been a pleasure.
All right, man.
Yeah, I hate to see though. Good stuff, man.
Thanks.
Definitely still.
Be got, definitely you, more coming.
You gotta get me that one song.
Oh yeah.
That we'll one song, definitely.
I'll get it done.
If you have second doubts about it, just remember me. I like this idea.
Yep.
It'll make my life complete. Those long nights, if I'm in here editing something, I go and turn it on and say, that's right, this is so great. But adios to everybody, and hopefully you had a good one. Yep. Thank you for coming in.
Thanks for having me.